This is Zara. This is Scar. And I'm Rachel. And this is my channel. If you guys read the title, then you know in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you my fitness journey and what changes I'm making for my health and this YouTube channel for the new year. I originally started my YouTube channel back in 2013 with a focus on makeup and fashion. Around 2016, I stopped making consistent videos and I started to lose inspiration for new videos. Ultimately, I lost confidence in myself. 2018 has been a huge year for me. I experienced a lot of heartache, but I also started this newfound journey to discovering myself through health and fitness. If I had to pick a word to describe my year, I would pick the word discipline. It's a skill I've never had before, but I've learned with my drive to become healthier. First things first, let me share with you the background to my fitness and health and the changes I noticed after I graduated high school. And then I'll share with you what my 2019 plans are. So let's go ahead and get into this video. I've always had a smaller body type, and in high school I participated in sports. But when I went off to college, I did not keep up a fitness routine and I ate whatever I wanted. Fast forward a couple years, I started to become very uncomfortable in my skin. I got sick regularly, my allergies were getting worse, I would wake up in the middle of the night and not be able to breathe, and I had never experienced that before. So naturally, you go to the doctors when you're not feeling well, right? So every time I went to the doctors, all they did was prescribe me something that didn't even really help my problems because it just kept coming back. I thought maybe, oh, I'm developing asthma because my brother and sister both have asthma. But no, the doctor said I wasn't. So what was wrong? Recently, on my Instagram, I briefly mentioned the start of my health journey with cutting back my refined sugar and the baby steps I took to getting back into the gym. It all started when I became interested in educating myself about food and the effects it has on your body. My eyes were open to how horrible I was eating and how horrible those around me were eating. We load up on processed food and refined sugar while completely ignoring the bad effects it has on your body. We excuse weight gain by telling ourselves it's normal to gain weight as you get older. Mid-2017, I was introduced to nutrition scientist Dr. Rhonda Patrick because she was a guest on the Joe Rogan podcast. She's been a guest on several episodes and I'm gonna link them in the description box so you guys can take a listen because these episodes are packed with so much information and knowledge on food and the effects for your body and nutrition. I cut out all refined sugar after that. Yes, that means soda, cakes, cereal, cookies, ice cream. I stopped allowing myself to eat it. Within a couple weeks of that, I lost 10 pounds from that alone. I've always had a big sweet tooth, and the first couple weeks was not easy. But once I got through that withdrawal period, it became easier to say no to sweets. And now I physically feel better. My allergies aren't as bad, I don't have any breathing problems, everything. And now I get sick way less. Shortly after I changed my diet, my coworker asked me if I wanted to participate in the Savage Race. Those of you who don't know, the Savage Race is an obstacle course that spans about 7 miles with approximately 20 or so different obstacles. I had always wanted to try something like that, so I was like, sure, I'll sign up. But I knew to complete 90% of the obstacles, you need upper body strength, which I did not have. So then my coworker told me about this weightlifting fitness group she was a part of. It was about 4 to 5 girls with a trainer, and the trainer would set up different weight stations and be there to correct your form and just guide you through the workouts. He really helped me a lot because I lifted a little bit in high school with my track team, but I really didn't have that much experience. Signing up for the Savage Race ultimately helped me align a goal for myself. I had a lot of fun trying something new, and I impressed myself with what I was able to do. After the race was over, I wanted to do it again. This time, I created new goals for myself for the next race to complete certain obstacles that I had failed. In January 2018, our trainer decided to move to another city and leave the gym. This was a bummer because I was really enjoying the class, and now I had to figure out what I was gonna do. Should I stay at this gym and work with the new trainer, or should I take my fitness journey into my own hands? I ended up finding a gym that was cheaper and closer to my house, and it's worked out really well for me. I even met a girl who became a really good friend and a really good workout partner. Some days I didn't feel like going, she pushed me to go, and that's really important. But let me just say, while it is nice to have a workout partner, do not let the fact that you don't have one hinder you from your fitness journey. The first time you go to a gym, it's very intimidating. You don't really know where everything is, you don't know people, you're like embarrassed to do certain workouts. But sometimes all it takes is you going, getting the workout done, and then you'll feel accomplished and proud of yourself for doing it anyways. Then all you have to do after that is keep going, and you'll get more comfortable being there on your own. Now I have a gym friend, but sometimes our schedules don't work out, but I don't let her not being able to go stop me from going. And that's important for your fitness journey. My journey has not been perfect, and there are still days when I don't feel like going to the gym, but you have to discipline yourself to go and get your workout done. If you need a rest day, take it, but do not let yourself fall back into your old lazy habits. Sometimes I still want sweets, and it's mostly when people around me are indulging in some. Throughout 2018, I allow myself to have some here and there, in moderation, but every time I let myself have even a little bit, I almost instantly felt horrible. And I'm not talking about I felt guilty for having some, I mean I physically felt bad. I get headaches or my stomach gets upset. It's just not good. And it only happens now after I eat something with a lot of refined sugar. It's kind of amazing to witness how much my sugar tolerance has dropped. I always find it funny when people around me don't understand how I could give up sweets and how I do it and why I do it. And then they act like they never could. And that's because they're addicted to this stuff. I've been there. But I'm really glad I chose to give it up. I had to teach myself discipline, which was not easy, but it's 100% possible for anybody who wants to see changes in their life. Everyone is entitled to eat what they want to eat. I'm not trying to tell you how to live your life. I'm simply sharing my personal experience with you. Maybe you want to make that change for yourself, but that's your decision alone. But maybe my experience can help you take the steps to make the change. . 2019 has arrived, and a new opportunity to set goals for yourself is here. Granted, you can set goals for yourself anytime throughout the year, but since this is the goal setting season, why not set some goals? For me, I want to make more progress in my fitness and health because it's a lifestyle. I've seen great results in 2018, but remember how I said I would allow myself to have sugar here and there? Well, for 2019, I want to eliminate all refined sugar from my diet, including processed food and grains. I plan to use my YouTube channel to share my journey throughout the year, share what foods I make, and document the changes I've noticed. Eating right goes hand in hand with working out, and I know that's not the first time you've heard it, and that's because it's true. While I've already seen a lot of improvement on my body image, I'm looking forward to seeing how this change in my diet affects my health and how it improves my workout results. If I can do it, you can do it. So I'm gonna end this video with a quote. Work on yourself now, find beauty in life every day, live with meaning, purpose, and intention. Have a happy new year, go get it done.